All right, we're going to be factoring four terms of a polynomial by a grouping method is what it's called. So we have four terms here, and the first thing we always look for is if there's a common factor in all the terms of the polynomial, but there is not. Our second method is we've got four terms, we're going to group them together. So we put two terms together and another two terms together. So let's just put the first two terms together. We're going to kind of put them in a group. Plus, and then we're going to take the second two terms and then put them in another group. Now, if you have minus signs anywhere, you have to be very careful. And do remember to put the plus sign between the two parentheses. Out of the first set of parentheses, I look for the greatest common factor, and that'll be 3y squared. That'll give me a y plus 4 plus. Now we're going to look at the second parentheses. And there is no common factor, is there? But there really is a 1. If you want to think of it as having a coefficient, we could put a 1 there. It's not necessary, but you can do that. Now we're back to, well, we've got two big terms here, right? We have this whole term plus this whole term. Each of the terms has a common factor that we can pull out of y plus 4. So we can pull out a y plus 4, 3y squared plus 1. And that's our answer. Now, the way to check is by doing the FOIL method or the box method, any method you want, multiply it back out and make sure that you get the original. So to check, multiply. Remember, factoring is sort of going the opposite direction. Okay, now I happen to put the first two terms together. That might not have worked, in which case you would try putting maybe the first and third term together or the first and fourth term together. So what if I had redone this problem by putting a different two terms together, 3y cubed plus 12y squared plus y plus 4, but instead of putting the first two terms together, how about I put the 3y cubed and the y together, that's the third term, and the 12y squared plus 4 together, and let's see what happens. All right, so in the first set of parentheses, I could pull out a y, which gives me 3y squared plus 1, and in the second set, I could pull out a 4, which gives me 3y squared plus 1. Well, notice I have a common factor in each of these two big terms again. So I can pull out the greatest common factor of 3y squared plus 1, leaving it as y plus 4. Also correct. And again, you would multiply it out to make sure you got the same four terms. These are really the same. Just notice I've written the factors in a different order. That's the commutative property of multiplication. It doesn't matter if I write this parentheses first or if I put the 3y squared plus 1 first. There's still just two factors being multiplied together. If you would have tried putting the first and fourth term together, you would have gotten stuck. There's always one way it's not going to work, for sure. And it may not work no matter how you do it. So we're going to be giving you ones basically that you'll be able to factor usually. But you do have to make sure you have exactly the same factor in this step here. So what's in parentheses, be careful that they're exactly the same factor. Okay, so I want you to try factoring this polynomial using the grouping method. So put it on pause and try it. All right, let's go ahead and just put the first two terms together and see how that works out. AB minus 2A plus the second two terms together. All right, now within the first parentheses, I could factor out an A and I get B minus 2. And in the second parentheses, I could factor out a 3, And now I have a b minus 2 as a common factor in each of the two terms. So I can pull that out to the front. And a plus 3. And again, make a note, check by multiplying. So if you multiply it back out, you should get that same answer. Okay, this one is a little bit trickier because I have this minus sign in the middle here. So if you're going to factor by grouping the first two terms together and you want to put a plus sign, you'll have to remember that's a negative 3x that goes inside of here. All right, so this is when we could start it. All right, out of the first set of parentheses, I could take out an x squared and x minus 4. Here's my clue. You're hoping you're going to get an x minus 4 out of that other one over here. So let's see if that would, if it's possible to make that happen. You could say, well, I'm going to have to factor out a minus sign here. See how you could factor out a 3 out of what's in those parentheses? You could always factor out a 3 or a negative 3. You're going to want to choose to factor out a negative 3 so that you'll get an x. Right, that'll give you a negative 3x, and then this will have to be a minus 4 to get back to plus 12, negative 3 times negative 4. Now we've got an x minus 4 that we could pull out to the front times an x squared minus 3. And again, check by multiplying it back out to see if you really get x cubed minus 4x squared minus 3x plus 12. Okay, so this is what you're going to watch out for. When you've got x cubed minus 4x squared minus 3x plus 12, this is not the same as x cubed minus 4x squared minus 3x plus 12. You cannot just put the minus sign in front of the parentheses. That's not the same. In fact, you can see right away, if you try distributing, this would be a negative 12, but here it was supposed to be a positive 12. So if you want to put a minus sign out in front of the parentheses like that, you are going to have to change this sign here to a minus sign as well. So that's what it's not. You can do this. You can say, well, I'll group the first two together. And then I'm going to factor a minus sign out of both terms, so it'll have to change signs. That'll have to be a 3x and a minus 12. That will work. Okay? So if you were going to finish this, then you would be factoring a 3 out because you've already taken care of that minus sign out in front. And from there, it's the same as it was before. Okay, so be very careful. Okay, let's try this one. All right, we could do this similar to the previous problem. Put the first two grouped in one parenthesis. And if I want, I could pull out the minus sign now, which means you've got to change the signs of both the negative 12y, so that becomes a 12y, and instead of minus 16x, that's plus 16x. So that's one way of putting the minus sign out in front of the parentheses on the first step. The other way is to write plus a negative 12y and a minus 16x. All right, out of this first term, this first parentheses, we can pull out an x. And out of the second term, let's see, we could pull out a 4. All right, now we look at it and we say, well, is there a common factor? Right? Over here in this big first term, I have 4x plus 3y, and over here I have 3y plus 4x. Yes, that's exactly the same. And if you happen to write in alphabetical order, 4x plus 3y, it's more obvious that it's really the same factor. So you could pull that out to the front, 4x plus 3y times x.